This is recitation 8, and today we introduce the magnetic field, and we will work with magnetic forces. We already know that if we have an electric field created in some region of space, and if we place a charged particle in this electric field, then there will be force exerted on this charged particle, which is QE. And this force will be in the same direction as electric field as if the particle is positively charged particle, and force will be in the opposite direction to the direction of electric field if Q is negative. Now, if we create a magnetic field in some region of space, from experiments, we know that there will be force acting on a charged particle, and this force will be Q, and then velocity of the particle cross B, cross product between velocity of the particle and the magnetic field. Please remember, we have cross product here, which means that we are looking for perpendicular components of velocity and the magnetic field that will give us non-zero force. If this particle has zero velocity, if it does not move, then force will be zero. Or if the particle is neutral, if it doesn't have a charge, then the force will be zero. So if we have now both electric and magnetic field created in some region of space, then we have to add these two forces as vectors. I will factor out Q, and then in parentheses, I will have E plus V cross B. Now, as an example, let's consider a positively charged particle, charged Q, that is moving to the right with a velocity, with a given velocity V. And this particle is placed into magnetic field, given magnetic field, with constant magnitude B. This is uniform magnetic field. The direction of this magnetic field is into the page. This circle with this cross shows that the magnetic field is into the page. What will be the force exerted on this charged particle? The force will be Q, V cross B. The velocity is perpendicular to the magnetic field, so cross product is just product. It is QV times B. And now we need to figure out what is the direction of this force. To find out the direction, you need to bring these two vectors, V and B, together. This will help you a lot. This is V. This is B. And now you need to use right hand, because it is right hand rule. You cannot use your left hand. And you know what? I will be using my left hand, ironically, because what you see my mirrored image. So for me, the correct solution will be if I use this hand. So what you need to do, you use your right hand, you put your fingers along velocity vector. You move them, you curve them towards the magnetic field vector, and your thumb will show you the direction of the force. And in this case, my thumb showed me the direction of the force. The force is up. So we have it up. We solve the problem, the force has its magnitude and direction. Now let me change my mind. Now for a change, we will have a negatively charged particle and everything else will be the same. So negatively charged particle enters the magnetic field with velocity that is to the right. Magnetic field is in, same. This is the magnitude of the this is the direction of the magnetic field. It's constant, it has magnitude B. Please find the force acting on this negatively charged particle. Magnitude is Q, but it is negative, okay? So, what will be the magnitude of this force? I take absolute value of Q, and then V and B are perpendicular to each other, V and B. Now, what will be the direction? We need to figure out what is the direction. So, I start these two vectors together. V is to the right. B is into the page. I remember that this is a negatively charged particle, negatively charged particle. So what is V cross B? V, I turn my fingers towards B. My thumb shows me the direction up, but Q is negative. So negative in vertical direction up means direction down. So the force exerted on the negatively charged particle will be down. This is the force. So this time it will be down.